community. If we are going to baptize, it should be because we have decided to follow Jesus and his way of life. Because baptism then would signify a new life, a new beginning, a new washing, a cleansing. We have done, we have finished with the old thing, and now we are ready to start something else. And part of following the life of Jesus is to come to regular worship. That's what the commandment says. Keep the day of the Lord holy. And it's probably the one day we resist not coming, because it's the day when we can sleep late and do this and do that. So if we're not doing the bare minimum, then we can't really talk about having a life of faith. So if we baptize because we have made a decision to follow Jesus, then we are on the right route. We are motivated properly. So baptism should be something that is special. It should not be an event. It shouldn't be an event, you know. So we work towards the day of baptism, and once it's done, well then that's it. We go back to our regular life, and that's what happens most times. Baptism should be an invitation to change and to renewal. That's the mindset we're coming with. Even if we are baptizing babies, it's not the baby's decision, but it's the parents' decision. It's the godparents' decision. It's the family's tradition. And therefore the force of faith should also be there to give to the baby. So the baby can say nothing on his own or on her own, but it's the parents who are saying, God, we celebrate faith, we live faith, we want to continue in this faith, and therefore we want everybody who belongs to us to be in faith. So if we are going to baptize, it should be because we want Jesus in our lives. And if Jesus comes into our lives, what do we say with worship is? It is a response to God. So if God has given us this grace of being in faith, then in response, then we and back to God, our celebration of faith. So parents and godparents must be aware that they have a responsibility to develop faith, the faith of the children that they're bringing for baptism. And that is why we cannot have non-Catholic people as godparents. In a simple fact, in addition to being law, the canon law says we can't have anybody who's non-Catholic as a godparent. Right? But it makes sense. If this person is going to witness to this child, to the faith that they are bringing the child into, then the person must be living the faith. If not, we don't bound to have godparents. Give the child a book and let them go and read, and they can read everything that they want. But faith is not about what we read. Faith is about what we live, and it's about what we witness to. We can't do nothing about the parents. But the same thing applies. If you're bringing a child for baptism, it's because you are celebrating faith and you are living faith and you are inviting faith into the life of this child. So everybody who's concerned with that baptism must be people who have so appropriated their faith that they want it to be shared with this child. And as they grow, this child must see it happening in the parents' life and in the grandparents' lives, you know. Adults who journey the RCIA program, well, they could make the decision for themselves. So they must be aware that they're taking on a personal responsibility to pursue and to develop faith. And that's a critique I have of our Catholic community in general. Once we finish confirmation class, we're done with studying the faith here. But we must go and find out things on our own. We can't teach everything at Mass. Mass is not for teaching. Mass is not to instruct everybody every time. That's not what Mass is for. Mass is to celebrate the liturgy of the word, and that is specific, and it is to celebrate the breaking of the bread. Sometimes it may give occasion or opportunity to teach on some things, but that's not its purpose, essentially. Yeah. So we must go and find out what we want to find out when we have to investigate anything at all concerning our faith life. And these days of internet, oh gosh, you can find anything you want. Anything you want you can find. You'll have too much information when you go on this have to look. I get confused. So number 1271 in the Catechism, baptism then constitutes the foundation of communion among all Christians. And I want to make that point also clear. It includes those who are not yet in full communion with the Catholic Church. So baptism brings us into our faith life, but it also constitutes a foundation for all Christian communities to be able to share together. We call it ecumenism or interfaith dialogue. So once a person is baptized, it means that we have a common ground on which to talk, to stand, and on which to share. Because Jesus welcomes everybody and includes everybody in his life. So baptism is one of those very, very special moments in our lives. And that is where our faith begins. Begins with our accepting Jesus, the life of the Spirit, into our lives, and we hope that we'll continue to celebrate it. Amen.
Amen.
So if you have this hymn book, the old one or the new one, because it's a new one too, right? It's number 392. 392, we have come into this house.
Shall I stand?
decided to follow Jesus and his way of life. Because baptism then would signify a new life, a new beginning, a new washing, a cleansing. We have done, we have finished with the old thing, and now we are ready to start something else. And part of following the life of Jesus is to come to regular worship. That's what the commandment says. Keep the day of the Lord holy. And it's probably the one day we resist not coming, because it's the day when we could sleep late and do this and do that and do the other. So if we're not doing the bare minimum, then we can't really talk about having a life of faith. So if we baptize because we have made a decision to follow Jesus, then we are on the right road. They are motivated properly. So baptism should be something that is special. It should not be an event. shouldn't be an event, you know. So we work towards the day of baptism, and once it's done, well then, that's it. It's not. We go back to our regular life. And that's what happens most times. Baptism should be an invitation to change and to renewal. That's the mindset we're coming with. Even if we are baptizing babies, it's not the baby's decision, but it's the parents' decision. It's the godparents' decision. It's the family's tradition. And therefore the force of faith should also be there to give to the baby. So the baby can say nothing on his own or on her own, but it is the parents who are saying, God, we celebrate faith, we live faith, we want to continue in this faith, and therefore we want everybody who belongs to us to be in faith. So if we are going to baptize, it should be because we want Jesus in our lives. And if Jesus comes into our lives, what do we say worship is? It is a response to God. So if God has given us this grace of being in faith, then in response, then we hand back to God our celebration of faith. So parents and godparents must be aware that they have a responsibility to develop faith, the faith of the children that they're bringing for baptism. And that is why we cannot have non-Catholic people as godparents. In a simple fact, in addition to being law, the canon law says we can't have anybody who's non-Catholic as a godparent, right? But it makes sense. If this person is going to witness to this child, to the faith that they are bringing the child into, then the person must be living the faith. If not, we don't bound to have godparents. Give the child a book and let them go and read, and they can read everything that they want. But faith is not about what we read. Faith is about what we live. And it's about what we witness to. We can't do nothing about the parents. But the same thing applies. If you're bringing a child for baptism, it's because you are celebrating faith, and you are living faith, and you are inviting faith into the life of this child. So everybody who's concerned with that baptism must be people who have so appropriated their faith that they want it to be shared with this child. And as they grow, this child must see it happening in the parents' life and in the grandparents' lives. You know. Adults who journey the RCIA program, well, they could make the decision for themselves. So they must be aware that they're taking on a personal responsibility to pursue and to develop faith. And that's a critique I have of our Catholic community in general. Once we finish confirmation class, we're done with studying the faith. But we must go and find out things on our own. We can't teach everything at Mass. Mass is not for teaching. Mass is not to instruct everybody every time. That's not what Mass is for. Mass is to celebrate the liturgy of the word, and that is specific, and it is to celebrate the breaking of the bread. Sometimes it may give occasion or opportunity to teach on some things, but that's not its purpose, essentially. Yeah. So we must go and find out what we want to find out when we have to investigate anything at all concerning our faith life. And these days of internet, oh gosh, you can find anything you want. Anything you want you can find. You'll have too much information when you go and start to look. I get confused. So number 1271 in the Catechism, baptism then constitutes the foundation of communion among all Christians. And I want to make that point also clear. It includes those who are not yet in full communion with the Catholic Church. So baptism brings us into our faith life, but it also constitutes a foundation for all Christian communities to be able to share together. We call it ecumenism, or interfaith dialogue. So once a person is baptized, it means that we have a common ground on which to talk, to stand, and on which to share. Because Jesus welcomes everybody and includes everybody in his life. So baptism is one of those very, very special moments in our lives. And that is where our faith begins. Begins with our accepting Jesus, the life of the Spirit, into our lives, and we hope that we'll continue to celebrate it. Amen.
Amen.
So if you have this hymn book, I don't know, the old one or the new one, because there's a new one too, right? It's number 392. 392, we have come into this house.
Should I stand? We have come into this house.